I'm Peggy.
I'm Laura.
And we're
UrbanBooz.
So you can't
still
see.
In the purple.
UrbanBooz. Yeah, keep it on with the purple theme. Mm-hmm. Holiday season. Guess what we got for y'all? We should have some soca music in the background.
Oh,
okay,
yeah.
I don't know how to soca dance, but you know, I can kind of make the move going. And here is the Acca, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, Sorel wine that we're going to try today.
Sorel wine. We're going to talk a little bit about what sorel is. Sorel is tasty. Sorel is delicious. Sorel is a very standard Caribbean, it's a plant, actually.
The hibiscus flower.
It's not a berry.
So this is a sparkling, what is it? A sparkling wine.
Mm-hmm.
And as Laura said, made from the hibiscus.
Mm-hmm.
Flower or a plant or a stem.
It's a flower.
Y'all correct me. You know, I don't know. Ooh.
But it's sparkling and that's plenty.
It's pretty.
It's very pretty. This one, we are not sponsored as of yet.
No.
This one was expensive.
I shouldn't say that. I might get beeped. It was $30, y'all. So
$30, so it better be tasty.
It better be really
tasty.
And
when I say better
be, pretty.
Because I am the I'm the $2 Chuck girl. This is how I started. That was my intro to wine. Go down to TJ's. There's one TJ's in New York. And if I was in the area, I would pick up a couple of bottles of wine and try them and just see what I liked.
Mm-hmm.
$2, you know, it's cheaper than, you know, a can of soda. You know, a 2-liter soda. So you get that, you want to elevate. You try something new. $30, I'm trying something new, and I expect it to be tasty, and I expect it to stand up to my meal. If I run down to Gloria's on Nostrand Avenue, I'm giving shout-outs to everybody, but that's my spot to get Trini food, and I get my curry chicken, my roti wrap, and some puluri, and I have my $30, because I really do believe that our food deserves good flavors, it deserves good wine to go with it. And if I get that, it better taste good. That's what we're doing.
Yeah, and I live in the heart of Jamaica, Queens, so we have some wonderful options and more Jamaican food. And certainly, besides having a cup of soda with my curry chicken or my stewed chicken, you know, it would be nice.
Chicken.
And I've always loved sorrel. Am I pronouncing it right? I always loved it. So this kind of appealed to me. So we're going to taste it.
Mm-hmm.
What about the smell? We didn't talk about smell.
I didn't notice anything.
I smell effervescence.
Right. We smell the bubbliness of it. It tastes like sorrel.
Oh.
And sorrel, if you don't know it, it's tasty.
I taste the ginger.
I taste ginger. But I taste a little cinnamon.
Yeah, I taste the cinnamon. Oh,
I taste maybe a little allspice. He didn't hold back on the flavor. Everybody doesn't make sorrel the same. There's no uniform. Just like, you know, you can taste ginger ale, Canada Dry ginger ale versus Schweppes ginger ale.
Mm-hmm.
There is no, we don't have a lot of sorrel brands to compare this with.
Right.
And it's the same thing, you know, with the wine or with the drinks. I have a friend who makes sorrel. She makes it, she uses a lot of ginger. There's a bit of sugar, but it's not overly sweet. It is a delicious. And I will say that her sorrel has this is pretty. This looks like a dark rosé to me. Her sorrel looks like a deep red wine because she lets it age a little bit. It's not a wine. Hers isn't fermented at all, so it's just her process of the way she makes it. And sorrel is a labor-intensive drink. The way they, you know, when her daughter was complaining to me, I was like, oh, I love your mom's sorrel. She was like, please, don't ask her for that. She's going to make it, which means she'll have to make it, and she would have to help, and it's... You know, you're rinsing and you're boiling and you're moving things from one area to another as the rinsing comes out. It's a process.
But how clever of him to make this, you know, something accessible to probably us who are not from the Caribbean, who
We don't have the recipe,
but we've tasted it, we liked it, and it just takes it to another level. So that's really, really interesting that he would do that. And
this would go well with your, one of my son's favorite dishes is oxtails. And we all think, oxtails, used to be poor people food. But now oxtails, how many pounds? It's $8 a pound.
Yeah,
and it's mostly bone. So you're paying mostly for bone. These bones. However, this, if properly, you know, you had your peas and rice and your oxtails, this would go with it. And this, mm-hmm. oxtails are already going to be elevated because it's a labor-intensive dish. But you want to, if you're putting labor into your food and you want it to taste good, you can serve it with this.
And you want to have a grown-up version of sorrel?
Right.
And then the maker of this, he is from Guyana. Mm-hmm. And his name is Chris. Hopefully we'll be talking to you soon, Chris. He said he'll be part of our podcast soon, mm-hmm. so we could find out about what his journey was that mm-hmm. made, that brought him to making this beautifully decorated bottle. I will say to him, like, couldn't the price point have been lower? But then, to your point about the labor intensity, I'm sure it's the same type of labor intensity in making it, but still.
A lot goes into regular sorrel that's non-alcoholic. Yeah.
Right.
You know, a lot goes into it. And that's me not ever getting involved with it, just hearing secondhand from someone else that a lot goes into it.
Wow.
It tastes amazing.
Wow.
This is really good. $30. This is holiday.
I know, this is for the holiday.
Maybe that's
special
why
occasion.
This is, right. It's a special occasion wine, which is, you know, I guess that's what you want. You want your wine to be special occasion. You want it to be, it is special.
Yeah.
This is definitely special.
The good thing is, I think if you can look it up, if you go on, it's Acca mm-hmm. Nectar, I believe, they are found in Brooklyn and in Queens. It's found in the New York City area, which is so very, very cool.
Mm-hmm.
So at least this one is not so limited.
Right.
So he has like figured out a formula for getting his stuff distributed. I did find this at a liquor store, AAA liquor store in Cambria Heights. So I would say go on the website. It's Acca. Let's see what else it says here.
Acca
Sorel.
Sorrel.
Demi Secco. Look it up, y'all.
I said when we opened it. It looked like champagne, and I was like, oh, is this Prosecco? What's going on?
Right.
Demi Secco.
Demi Secco.
Demi Secco.
Mm.
Tasty, and it'll hold up.
Okay? Yeah. So for your holiday planning, have a bottle of this on your table, especially mm-hmm. if you have friends from the Caribbean. They'll give you your honest opinion. Me, with my American palate, I like it. And I think there's some level of authenticity that is there that I think everyone will appreciate.
Yeah.
So stay tuned for our interview with the maker. That should be very, very interesting. Mm-hmm. We certainly look forward to bringing probably the culmination of all his dreams and desires with this bottle to you.
Right. And enjoy it. You will enjoy it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So don't forget, you can find us on Facebook. If there's other wine, spirits, beers that you would like us to review, taste, and see what it tastes like with some comfort food, let us know.
Mm-hmm.
Post it on Facebook, Instagram, DM us, tweet us, tell us saw what we did. Let us know if you liked it. Any tips? We're open.
Right.
We're just two friends that are carrying on our normal conversations, and we're just bringing it to you.
Exactly. This is normally, hey, I found this wine.
Exactly.
I'm going to bring it over, and I will note this. This is one of the first times that since we've been doing this, Peggy didn't say, oh, I'll make a rosé. I'll make a sangria out of this.
I know.
I'll make a punch. Peggy just drank it and said, oh, this is good.
I know. That's a first for me.
That is a first for her because she's almost like, look, I like it. I'll buy it again. Or, it's all right. And Peggy's like, no, I think I'm going to zhuzh it up. I'm going to make
it.
Right. Like, Peggy's just like, oh, I'm going to drink this.
Yeah, because when I say I'm going to zhuzh it up into a sangria, that's code for I ain't drinking it by itself. I need to do something else to elevate it for my palate.
Right. And I'm just like, if I don't like it that much, then I'm just not going to get it again.
I know.
Yeah, Peggy's like, well, we can get it again, and we can do this, and we can do that. I'm not doing all that.
Yeah, that's a one offer. When I say that, I'm gonna try you once, and I'm not going to do it again. Mm-hmm. But here, I really, really like the cinnamon, the cloves.
The cloves.
Oh my God.
Cloves. And it's tasty.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't like one of my children. She doesn't like cloves in anything. It's like, why do you always put cloves in it?
I know.
But she might like this.
So guys, look for Acca. Look for
Acca Sorrel.
And then, okay, remember, when I went into the store to buy, when I asked for, by name, Acca, the guy didn't know what the heck I was talking about. And then he said, the sorrel wine? And I said, yes. So you know what? Maybe when you go in there, ask for the sorrel sparkling wine and you won't be disappointed. You really won't. So until next time, this is Urban Booz signing off. We're always exploring what's good.
Sip by sip. See you next time.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Cheers.
Cheers.